How you doing? Welcome to Muscle Gauge Nutrition. As you all know, with the 16-week workout, or actually it's actually an 8-week workout, I just happened to do it for 16 weeks with the results. With the 8-week workout, we have a very, very dynamic workout. What it is a high-intensity, high-repetition workout which shreds you down and gets you looking absolutely stunning. I'm going to take you through the workouts for a normal chest day. This is going to be a several-part series where I'll go through your chest day, your leg day, your back day, as well as your cardio day. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you through it all, and I'll also add a supplemental video, which will explain some of the other workouts you'll see in the workout that you might not see throughout the series. Because you know, workouts change every 2 weeks, so that's something that's actually will be very, very informative for you. Today, we're starting with chest. First thing we're going to do is we're going to start with the bench here. I've already warmed up. Set of 15, 225. As you all know, meaning that you have the workout with the bench, the first week we have 4 sets of 15. So that being said, I have another 4 sets which I'm going to bang out, and then I'll catch you with our next thing, which is dumbbell flies. We are now on to dumbbell flies. One thing you want to make sure you do is if you start getting heavy with a fly, you got to make sure you watch your elbows and your shoulders. It's a really easy way to get injured. Make sure you watch yourself, and as you get heavier, your arms are going to have to start coming in a little bit. Got me some 50-pound weights right here. Let's do it. There's your dumbbell fly, good form, so make sure you use proper breathing technique and proper form. I went on some 50s right there. We got 2 more exercises to do. And that's 2 more exercises to do for dumbbell flies, 3 sets of 15. Right now, start feeling the fatigue set in. You're done with bench, you're done with flat dumbbell benches. Next thing you're doing, we have incline dumbbell presses. Got some 80-pound weights here. Let's get it. So you have good form, good technique, and picking up the weights at all points. Use your leg. Let's go. Bust it out. Hard work, dedication, get you looking right. Got 3 more sets. Getting to the end of the workout, like I said, workout should only take about 45 minutes to an hour. We're done with bench, we're done with dumbbell flies, also done with dumbbell incline. That's what we gotta do, close grip bench. Let's get it. One set down, 3 more to go. Let's go. How you guys doing? I'm on the final exercise. Got a decline wide grip bench press. By this point, pretty much fatigued. So we got a lower weight on there. Gonna get 15. Give 3 sets of 15. I'm gonna have Eric here spot me. Can't. up. Make sure you have a nice wide grip on this. Let's get it. Thank you. It's the last workout before a push-up complex or max to 100, how fast you can get to 100 with your push-ups. Intense workout, like I said. I also have a supplement video coming out with some of the other exercises you'll see throughout the weeks that aren't included in this workout, mainly for the chest day. This is the end of the workout. Battery died on the camcorder, so there's never an excuse not to finish a workout, so I'm gonna start all over. I got to about 60 before the battery died, so I'm going to start at zero. Fast as you can to get to 100 push-ups. It'll be an end of your chest workout. Pretty much every day you do chest, it's either going to be this or a push-up complex, which you'll see in the supplemental video. We've gone through your bench press, your dumbbell flies, incline dumbbell, close grip bench, and decline barbell. And now we're going to wrap it up with push-ups as fast as you can to 100. Don't have my time with me, so I want you guys to count for me, and let me know how well I do. 70 without stopping. I got 30 more to go. As fast as you can. Let the arms loosen up a little bit. Let the chest loosen up. Got 30 more. I'm trying to get at least 20 here. You guys that have done it, I commend you. Always push yourself to beat your last time. Five more. Tremendous stress on your chest, triceps, and shoulder, your overall chest. It's incredible. Five more. Let's finish off. That's it, 100 push-ups. Hopefully you can beat me, because I'm always going to beat myself the next time I do it. I know that for sure. Thanks for working out with Muscle Gauge Nutrition, and next episode we'll be looking at legs.